All right, next up we have some instructors from the Breda University of Applied Sciences. Welcome.
Hello.
Hey, Chris.
Hello.
Hi, hi.
Maybe we'll get started with a little introduction of each from each of yourselves. Let's start with Ronnie.
Hi there, my name is Ronnie Franken. I'm Education Manager of Visual Arts at Breda University of Applied Sciences in the Netherlands. And I'm also a teacher procedural modeling, so that's why I'm here.
Hi there, my name is Robbie Grigg. I'm the Educational Manager for Programming. I help students with C++ and working with consoles.
Hello, my name is Zoran Narizanovic. I'm a teacher for Visual Art and Tech Art.
Hello, I'm Bojan Endovskin, and I'm a teacher for Programming, and I also teach a bit of Mathematics. And I'm here today because I'm also organizing Everything Procedural Conference. You'll hear a tiny bit more about the conference later.
Excellent. So what's the presentation today going to be about?
Yeah, so today we want to take a chance to talk a little bit about our program, also about our teaching approach, how we have integrated procedural and also Houdini in our curriculum. We will do this by going a little bit back in history, because I think we have quite a strong legacy in using Houdini, especially for game development. We will talk a little bit about proceduralism and Houdini in the 4 years of our bachelor. Then I think we will talk a little bit about the procedural conference, like Bojan already mentioned. After that, we will look into the future of proceduralism, things like AI, and how we think that will shape and form our education, but also industry in the future. And then we will wrap it all up. And then I hope we have given you a bit of an insight in how we achieve things here in Breda.
Terrific. Well, let's get started.
Okay, thank you.
Welcome at our beautiful campus. Welcome at Breda University of Applied Sciences. Welcome to Breda, the Netherlands. Breda University of Applied Sciences is a small-sized international higher education institution in the Netherlands. We have programs in 8 different domains, of which we are in the Academy for Games and Media. Today we are representing the games programs that consist of a 4-year bachelor and a 1-year master. These are both international programs, taught in English, with students from over more than 20 different nationalities. Our focus is on AAA game development, so that means games that require high production values and are meeting industry standards, industry production pipelines and industry tools. We embraced proceduralism and Houdini from the start of the program, and we want to share our experience with that with you today. In this talk, we want to highlight our program, how proceduralism and Houdini fit in our curriculum and in our project structure. We want to share our unique teaching approach and how this progresses across the years. We want to highlight our Everything Procedural Conference. We will finish looking ahead on how we think proceduralism will affect our education even more in the future and future demands in industry. Our games program started in 2006, and we introduced Houdini as a development tool in 2008 as part of the first third-year curriculum. It was introduced back then by Kim Goossens, who was a senior lecturer from 2008 to 2014. And some of these learning materials can still be found online. Maybe you've seen them, maybe you've learned from them, because they feature the NHTV watermark, as we were called back then. In 2016, we were one of the first schools to be Houdini certified, especially in the area of games development. From the start, we recognized the importance of proceduralism for game development, because of the size of games becoming bigger and bigger. So the sheer amount of content now became tremendous at that point. We also recognize that the use of proceduralism means that you can work in a non-destructive way, which again, for a bigger game project, is a very important benefit. For that reason, we moved Houdini and proceduralism already to the first year curriculum to make sure that students early in their career get exposed to the benefits of proceduralism. I think that with Houdini and proceduralism being part of our curriculum from the start, by now we have developed quite a good understanding of how to teach and introduce this subject to new students and new developers. By now, many game studios actually recognize our program for our expertise on the subject. And also, if we look at the places that our students, our graduates and alumni go to, it seems that we have quite some impact on the use of that technology in future games. Lots of our alumni are now working on future development pipelines for new and big upcoming AAA games.
So how do we make this happen? We've organized our education into projects with clear constraints and requirements. These projects are each aligned with one of the main 4 phases we recognize in game development. these being concepting, pre-production, production, and release. The projects define the learning opportunities, skills, and knowledge we want our students to obtain. This way, subjects are not isolated into separate courses, but integrated into a bigger context, working towards a clear end product and target platform.
For projects, students pick a role, of which procedural can be one, and join our project or game labs for full working days, where there's time for instructions, supervision, feedback and communication with our team, if that's applicable. But foremost, this gives them the experience of working in a simulated studio environment. They work on real projects, taking industry roles, using industry standard production tools for development, source control, as well as project management.
Since we have not organized our subjects around courses, our curriculum is not stuck or locked into predefined content. With this, we and our students have a lot of freedom to switch and adapt. We trust our students to take responsibility for their own learning. This makes them become very creative problem solvers, developing their own solutions for unique problems instead of just copying and repeating traditional course content.
An important component to make this work is our experienced staff. All have a serious amount of industry experience and come from senior positions from a variety of studios. They have worked on similar problems and challenges that we offer our students. They push and direct students into possible areas for improvement and development. They provide solutions and help to set the direction of the learning path and role the student wants to develop.
Another unique element I want to address is our guilds. In our project week, we have one set day apart for lectures, workshops, masterclasses, guests from industry, and our guilds. Think of this day as a mini conference every week. In this, the guilds can be best described as learning communities or special interest groups, where students, master students, alumni, and industry all share best practices in an area of expertise. To give a few examples, we have guilds for technical art, animation, motion capture, and deep learning, to name a few. Attendance to these guilds is open to all, across all years, across all disciplines. Here, first years learn from third years, alumni, industry, and even the other way around.
To give you a bit of insight of how we use Houdini in practice, we want to give you an overview of the 4 years of our bachelor. The focus of student development basically changes across those 4 years, where we have given themes to the years to basically describe what their focus is. So the first year is really foundation, the second year is focusing on exploration, year three collaboration, and year four is like a personalization year. In year one, students get their first introduction to Houdini and procedural modeling as part of a 10-week project. In this project, they have to create an animated scene for which they have to create a robot character, they have to rig the character, and animate the character. They also need to create a small environment and set extension for which they will use Houdini. Each student needs to complete all these components individually, and they will get instructions and video tutorials to get them started. As you understand, this is quite a condensed set of content they have to learn, but already at this stage, we allow them time to experiment and find other solutions and sources to accomplish their ideas. In the following year one project, where students work in multidisciplinary teams to create an actual game, they can pick a procedural as part of the production pipeline for that game. In year two, the focus is exploration. This means that students are encouraged to explore roles within game development, of which procedural is one. Instructions become less at this point, and students need to become more self-directed learners, doing their own research, finding their own resources, preferably instigated by industry developments and through industry talks and presentations. In year two, there are two projects focused on individual development, where students can work within their own constraints and focus. And there are two projects where students pick a role as being part of a bigger team. For this project, they have to take project constraints and team demands into account. For procedural, they can pick different teams. Think of building generation, vegetation, terrain. Think of level design or level decoration, and also visual effects. The bigger project with interdisciplinary constraints, challenges, but also opportunities is where the quality and strengths of our prospect graduates starts to shine. At this stage, the interaction with fellow team members that depend on the tools, the pipelines, and the assets that they create becomes undeniably important. Here they come up with unique solutions with their own development pipelines towards real playable games, real playable products.
Year 3 is kind of special for us because it's a culmination of all the efforts from 1 and 2, and students embark on a huge 40-week project, team project, and we are trying to simulate a game production environment inside of a classroom. Like most of our curriculum, everything is team-based and project-based. And it's a big help that majority of our staff comes from industry and they can really help students grow and reach their potential before the year 4. Year 4 is dedicated to internships and personal projects and even deeper specialization in different topics. As a part of a year 3 setup, we introduced what we call outsource groups. Outsource groups are dedicated groups of students with a similar specialty and similar interests, and one of them, of course, is also a Houdini or a tech art group. Houdini and tech art group has proven to be really successful in past years. We had a lot of success with the employment of those students and their results in general. They are acting as an independent outsource group for different game teams, so they can work simultaneously on 6 to 8 game teams, and they supply tools, procedural files, Houdini digital assets, everything supported all the way into the engine. And the topics range from crowd simulation, terrain generation, procedural asset generation, set dressing and scattering of assets, randomization of modular sets and assets. And most of the students that are part of this group, they stay in for the whole year, so that's a 40-week duration. In our school, blocks are 10 weeks. So for each block, each of those students also has a personal research stream that can be something completely different. So for example, they could do a terrain generation for a specific game team, but they could also research fluid simulation or destruction as their personal research area. Or like it often happens, as a personal research area, scripting languages like WEX, C#, Python, and so on. Year 3 is really important for us because Year 3 prepares students for production environment in a huge team. They are managing their own teams with a proper structure, with producers and lead artists managing their own departments. Those teams usually range somewhere from 20 to 30 people per team, and they are developing games based on the briefs that we supply for them at the beginning of the year. Production cycle is 40 weeks, and at the end of the production cycle we expect a proper release on any of the platforms, on Steam or in itch, or contributions to competitions and game festivals. That's why year 3 focus for our students is preparing their portfolio and establishing a network and reputation online so they are able to enter into internships and get a job after graduation. With Houdini students, it was always quite smooth, and I can say that for the last 4 or 5 years they are in really high demand, and most of students who specialize in procedural content generation and Houdini in general have no problem getting a job, and also usually they have more than enough offers to pick and choose from them. Year 3 and 4 are really important for our students because that's the time when they get to experience internships or they specialize deeper in the chosen topic in personal projects. Both of those years are leading them towards a successful graduation, and past years that we are tracking our success rate and employment rate, they are both really high, and most of the students end up in a company that they desire. For Houdini aspect of this work, most of the Houdini students tend to go to internships, and they are also in high demand. The content they produce during year 3 gives them a lot of exposure and attention from future employers, and they end up in companies from Japan to US, all around Europe, and we had really successful stories from Remedy, Square Enix, Ubisoft, Guerrilla, of course. So we are really happy with the success of Houdini students after graduation.
EPC, or Everything Procedural Conference, is a project that we started in 2016. We've seen different conferences that are covering the topic of procedural generation, sometimes from the perspective of games, sometimes from the perspective of film and TV. But there hasn't been one that we were aware of that has procedural as a main topic. And that was the main inspiration for starting the conference. Everything Procedural is an annual conference that we have been organizing from 2016. We have seen procedural as a topic being embedded into conferences about game development or film and TV, but what we really wanted to do is one that has procedural as a main focus point. The conference is a bit of a melting pot for people coming from different disciplines and different professions. It's a place where artists, designers, programmers all come together to share experiences and to learn from each other. We've covered topics like procedural level generation, assisted or automated world building, procedural audio, really a wide variety of topics. We have seen a very strong interest for the conference with people coming from the US or Japan here to be in Breda and be part of it. We have also noticed that the videos that we have posted from the conference are frequently being on the top of the search results whenever someone is searching for the topics that we covered in the conference. The industry has been of great help in organizing the conference. I think it's their way of giving back to the community. In particular, our own alumni have been very active on that front. It has also enabled us to keep the price very affordable. In particular for students, I think we have something like 80% discount on the ticket. We have been organizing a masterclass that lasts for 3 days with the Houdini as a topic. And SideFX in particular have been of great help in organizing the conference. They have helped us organize the Houdini masterclass, which is a 3-day intensive course, which runs in tandem with the conference. And we are hoping to organize it next year and to come back with a bigger lineup than ever.
So looking back, I'm really amazed at how far we've come. As a child, I remember learning about how you could place within a triangle dot after dot, selecting one corner, randomly going towards one of the other corners, placing a dot, repeating that process again and again. And slowly but surely, we had the Szczepinski triangle appear, a self-similar fractal. This is amazing. From there, I was so inspired that I was making plasma, fractals, generating terrain, and from there, dungeon generators. But that is nothing compared to what I'm seeing our students do today and what they might do in the future. And I know if I'd been given a tool like Houdini when I was young, I couldn't even dream what I'd be creating today. So looking into the future of education, we see procedural and AI being a very important part for all students, not just some programmers or technical artists. We've always believed that being somewhat technical is really important in making you effective in game development. This means a little bit of scripting to help automate what you do in your tools has always gone a long way. But going forward, having the skills of procedural and AI can take that even further, and that's why this is so important. We want students to be inspired to come up with new ideas, like Ubisoft's commit assistance, reviewing code check-ins and identifying errors before they're part of the build and actually reducing development time and testing time. Bringing procedural more meaningfully to other elements of gameplay, for instance, procedural narrative and how that might make a community of NPCs behave more believably over a period of time. To actively explore how evolutionary AI combined with deep learning and procedural may craft game characters of the future and ones that easily surpass the pitfalls of the uncanny valley. A lot of change is coming to development pipelines. This brings with it a lot of simplification, but also a lot of new complexity. More and more powerful hardware is enabling games to do more and more in real time. Combine this with cloud services that allow you to do imaginable things compared to what you could do on your workstation alone. Real-time ray tracing and global illumination providing a whole new graphics pipeline and opportunities that go with it. Physics algorithms that provide ever more realistic environments where we could see destruction and simulations that can happen now in real time and provide these opportunities for us to create ever more believable game worlds. And these game environments may be the ones generated from adversarial networks, training to slowly improve and fine-tune the parameters of complex procedural models and all their parameters. And what does it mean if the game engine is the single source for the creation of both the game and the movie? What does this mean for future game development pipelines that will get the most out of this? Can we imagine future roles in the games industry? Do we move away working from the latest version only? Do we have movie-like editors, editing environments, gameplay puzzles, and creating cuts that are later selected? How will procedural and AI play a role in this path? Such new roles will require the skills and knowledge and application of procedural tools and AI tools, and this is really important. Now we are seeing how the maturing of game engine technology is also having big impacts, not just on the games industry, but also other industries. And those other industries are not yet exploring to their full extent how procedural tools and deep learning could be applied. So this also provides amazing opportunities, not just with us, but in other industries. The future may be unlimited, but we still need the people with the skills and knowledge to make the jump in getting these things to happen.
We hope this talk has given you an insight of how we have set up our curriculum, our project structure, and how proceduralism and Houdini fits into that. We keep pursuing our mission to excel at training the next generation of world-class game development professionals, and with this build on our legacy to bring great procedural talent to the industry. We want to thank Houdini for that terrific toolset. We also would like to thank the Houdini community, which has always been very open and collaborative. We would like to invite prospect students to apply to our program. We would also like to invite industry, if they want to learn and collaborate, if not, to join our next Everything Procedural conference.